Okay. Ready?
Mr. McDowell ready?
Yep.
Okay.
Everybody ready?
Hello, Bethel Park. My name's Amy Taylor, and I'm here from Bethel Park High School, where something's a little bit creepy, kooky, maybe a little mysterious and ooky. It's the Addams Family, the musical, and it's here. Bethel Park High School is putting on the musical of Addams Family from March 15th, 16th, 17th, through the 18th. We have a split cast, so really you can see it multiple times and still get great different performances. Have you gotten your tickets yet? If not, you still have time. You want to go online and get your tickets, and we're going to be interviewing some of the cast, the crew, some of the dancers, and take a little peek behind the curtain. Join us now, will you? Bethel Park, we're here to talk about the new dark comedy, the musical Addams Family, here at Bethel Park High School, four nights. It's going to be Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. It's done by a split cast. The cast will be opening night, which is the Wednesday, the Friday, and then it'll be the closing cast, which is the Thursday and the Saturday. We're going to interview them now, so let's hear what they have to say.
When you're an Addams, you need to have a little moonlight. When you're an Addams, you need to feel a little chill. You have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some poison in your day.
We're here with Nick Dell, and Nick Dell, you are playing the part of?
Gomez Addams.
Gomez Addams,
yes.
The lead. How wonderful. I'm thrilled for you. How is it playing Gomez?
It's very unique. It's a unique character. He's a little unhinged, so that's different, especially coming from playing Prince Topher last year, who was a very, you know, straight-laced kind of guy. It's opposite end of the spectrum, for sure.
So define unhinged. What is Gomez Addams about? What flavor do you bring to the role?
He's just crazy. I like to think that he's a little bit, what's the word
I'm looking
for? Eccentric, yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's goes up and down a lot in his emotions, very quickly. I don't know, I feel like... when you see it, it'll be a little bit more clear what I'm trying to say.
How did you prepare for the role? Because there is an accent involved, correct?
Yes, there
is.
Which
you do exquisitely, I might add.
Thank
you.
But
how did you prepare for that?
The accent specifically, I've done some work just like researching how to do Spanish accent, because I'm not, I wasn't particularly good at it. I like to think I've improved.
Mm-hmm.
The role itself was a little bit different. I remember when I was practicing for my callback audition, I went out. It was like a 40-degree night, and I went out and just walked through a graveyard in like shorts and a t-shirt, because when you're in Addams, you have to feel a little chill, and you got to be comfortable feeling that little chill out in the graveyard at night by yourself. It was Thanksgiving, actually. There was nothing else
going on
that time of day, so yeah.
And do you have a favorite line or a favorite scene?
Favorite line or favorite scene? I think my favorite scene is probably when I first meet the Beinecke family. And I have a sword, and I just like swinging it around any chance I'm given.
You had a sword last year as well.
I did, but this one's much better. The new sword,
it's new and improved.
Substantially better,
okay,
yes.
Okay, wonderful. And can you give me a line from this particular scene?
Yeah, sure. Where are we from? Funny you should ask. July 31st, 1715, the Spanish warship, Pico de Gallo, commanded by my great nautical ancestor. And I'll leave it there because
you leave it
I'm
there.
Gonna.
You don't want to give Bethel Park too much.
You guys can come
too
learn
much.
About the ancestors on show nights, please.
Come and learn about the ancestors, Bethel Park. Thank you so much for your time.
Yes, absolutely.
Bethel Park, we're here with Aaliyah Taylor. Hi, Aaliyah.
Hi.
And you play the role of?
Morticia Addams.
And what kind of a character is Morticia?
She's very dark, she's very creepy, and she's definitely the head of the family.
Mm-hmm. So. Is it a fun role to play?
It is so much fun. She's such a fun character.
And how did you prepare for playing this role?
Oh my goodness, it's such a headspace you have to get in to be just like such a dark character while also being romantic and being into sort of those like dark and creepy things. Mm-hmm. So, mm-hmm. yeah.
And it's fun.
It is so much fun.
Mm-hmm. And are you opening or closing cast?
I'm in the closing cast.
Which means you're Thursday and Saturday, correct?
Yes.
And do you have a favorite line or a favorite scene that you'd like to share with us?
My favorite scene is whenever the Addams family meets the Beinecke family, and there is just such chaos that goes on, and me and Gomez have to keep like a straight face while the most absolutely hilarious things go on. And it's mm-hmm. so much fun. Mm-hmm.
And do you do any solos?
I do. I have a song called Just Around the Corner.
Mm-hmm. Can you give us a little example of that song?
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Death is just around the corner, waiting patiently to strike. One unplanned electrocution. That's the kind of end I can comprehend.
I love it so much. That was so good.
Thank you.
And you also do a dance. Tell the viewers at home what kind of a dance you do.
I do a tango.
How long is this tango?
It's about like 8 minutes, I think.
Oh my goodness, that's a long tango.
It is a long tango.
How long did it take you to prepare for that?
It took a lot of time, mm-hmm. a lot of rehearsals, and mm-hmm. a lot of outside practice. Mm-hmm. So we gave up a lot of our lunches, study halls, mm-hmm. any time we could to just practice.
And you feel you're ready?
I hope so.
If you could describe for the viewers at home what the tango's like.
It's very romantic, mm-hmm. it's very passionate, it's very close together, mm-hmm. and it's fast.
And might you tell the viewers at home that they will be seeing red in your performance?
You could say that. You could say that.
Maybe you will. Well, congratulations on the role. And you are a junior this year?
I am.
We look forward to seeing many more from you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're an Addams.
You do what Addams always do.
Mi amor!
Will you love me forever and ever?
We shall remain as besotted with each other as the night we first met.
The first date you took me to see.
Death of a salesman.
How we laughed.
We're here with Noah Stiglitz, and you are playing Gomez.
Yes, I am.
Tell me about the character of Gomez.
Gomez is very passionate for his family. He loves his family more than anything. It's like the greatest thing in his life. So when, you know, some things start to happen and lives are start to change, you know, there are some issues that he runs into, but ultimately, you know, he's going to try to figure it out and do what's best for everyone in his family.
Mm-hmm. Are you enjoying playing the lead role?
I'm so enjoying playing the lead role, and Gomez is Hispanic and I'm Hispanic, so it's like really it's kind of fun because I've never got to play a Hispanic character before, so it's fun
fantastic.
To kind of touch in a little bit there. Yeah.
Now how did you prepare for the role of playing Gomez?
I mean, it's a lot of like studying other videos and like learning from other people as well as learning with your co-partner, so you have mm-hmm. to talk to each other. It's a lot of communication, a lot of videos, a lot of learning an accent, so mm-hmm. I think overall like It's a pretty fun gig.
Mm-hmm. So you do speak with an accent up there on stage.
We do speak with an accent.
And how long did it take you to perfect that?
I mean, it's really not much of an accent as much as it is just being able to roll your R's and being able
like
to...
Like a flavor,
I yeah.
I like it.
For sure.
And do you have a favorite scene or a favorite line from the
musical? I love my song, Not Today. It's near the end of Act 2. And it's just a fun song about why Morticia doesn't like Gomez anymore. Why, you know, what's going on in the relationship. And it's a good character building moment for
Morticia
Gomez.
Morticia doesn't
for sure.
like Gomez.
You'll have to come see what
oh,
happens.
I have to come and see and find out, as do you, Bethel Park. All right, and the name of the song that you're speaking of is what?
Not Today.
Can you give us just a few bars, a few lines
sure.
of Not Today?
Sure.
I remember well the day she poisoned me. No one else had cared enough to try. How did she uncover all the joys in me? All the way she promised I would die.
Bravo, bravo. Now, you are a junior, correct?
Yes, I am.
And you are opening cast?
Yes.
So you will be the Wednesday and Friday performer.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot wait to see you. Thank you so much for
Thank
your
you
time.
Thank you so much.
Bethel Park, we're here with Clara McGuff. And Clara, what role are you playing?
I'm playing Morticia.
Morticia, you're the lead. How fantastic. How does it feel to be Morticia?
It's wonderful. I don't usually get to play roles quite like her. There aren't many like her. She's a very unique character. She's a strong mother of the family, mm-hmm. and she gets to show that tender mother side encased in a very strong outer shell.
Mm-hmm. And how did you prepare for the role of Morticia?
Well, a lot of practice, of course, mm-hmm. because she's not anything like me as a person.
Mm-hmm.
I did a lot of practice at home.
Did you study the TV series or?
I did. I watched all of the movies from the 90s. I watched a little bit from the original TV series. I did also watch the new Wednesday series. But
of course,
they didn't,
everybody did.
Yeah, they didn't feature as much in that one, but I did get some good tidbits from that.
And what year are you?
I'm a junior.
You're a junior, so you still have one more juicy year to go, right?
I do, yes.
And what nights are you performing?
Wednesday and Friday.
So you'll be the opening cast.
Yes.
And can you tell the viewers at home, do you have a favorite scene, a favorite line, something that you'd like to share with us?
I do have a favorite scene. My favorite scene is probably the tango.
Oh, heart be still me. You do a tango.
Yes.
With Gomez.
Yes.
And how do you feel about that?
It's amazing. It's such an incredible number. I've never done tango before.
So you learned it here through
the
dance captain.
Yes.
And you're ready to be lifted above and spun around?
Yes.
Okay. Would you like to demonstrate a little bit of that to the viewers at home? What would you like to share with us? A line?
One of my favorite lines. I like the very opening line for Morticia.
Okay.
After Gomez introduces the family, he asks what it is that every Addams hopes for, and my response is darkness and grief and unspeakable sorrow.
Oh, I love it so much. Bethel Park, remember, Clara is opening cast. Come on out and see her and the rest of the performers. Thank you so much, Clara.
Thank you.
Daddy, please.
What?
If you love me.
What?
Do you love me, Daddy?
We're here with Megan DeHaven, and it looks like you are playing
Wednesday
Addams. Congratulations on the role.
Thank you.
How thrilling for you.
I'm so excited.
I'll bet you're excited. We're excited for you. Do you have any solos this performance?
I do.
How many?
I think two or three.
You have two or three solos.
Mm-hmm.
And what is your favorite one?
Pulled.
That's a
Pulled.
Lovely song.
Yes.
Yes. What year are you?
I'm a junior.
Junior. So you still have one more year of acting under your belt? I noticed you have a little ring around your neck.
Oh, yes.
Can you tell the viewers at home what this ring symbolizes?
Viewers at home, the plot of the story is Wednesday gets in a relationship and she hides this proposal and engagement from her family, and they go on this story of finding love and accepting love. So,
fantastic. How did you prepare for this role?
A lot of vocal training.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to Caroline Connell for the vocal training.
But you have the talent to back it up, let's be honest.
Thank you.
Hats off to you. Would you like to share with the viewers at home a little bit of Pulled?
Okay, you want me to sing?
They want you to sing.
All right. I'm being pulled in a new direction, but I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. Through my painful pursuit, somehow birdies took root. All the things I detested, impossibly cute. What do I do?
What do you do, Bethel Park? You come down, you see this one for closing cast.
Oh, yeah.
I love it so much. Thank you for the time.
Thank you.
Bethel Park, we are here with Elizabeth Robinson, and you are playing the role of Wednesday. Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
Is this the reason that you have your hair in braids? Because you're doing some method acting, like, until the performance?
I'm actually on my off night, so I just have to tie it up in a wig. But
I love it. How excited were you to get the role of Wednesday?
I was ecstatic. I did not see it coming at all, so I was really thrilled.
With all of your talents and all of your abilities, you didn't see it coming. I think we all did. Let me ask you, what is your favorite line or your favorite role? Your favorite scene, your favorite song?
Probably it's a tie between Pulled and Crazier Than You.
Oh, they're both really good. And is one in Act One, one in Act Two?
Yes.
Okay. Describe one of the songs for us.
I would say Crazier Than You is, it's Lucas and Wednesday kind of coming together in like a battle of who's crazier than the other one. Mm-hmm. Lucas is trying to just, you know, prove to her that he can be as crazy as she is.
Mm-hmm. And Pulled is about pulled in a new direction,
yes,
correct?
Yeah.
Which song would you like to sing a little snippet for us?
I'll probably do Pulled, just the first little.
Please indulge us.
All right. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face. I'm enthused.
You don't look very enthused, do you?
Ew.
Now, this character on stage, she's pretty solemn. She's pretty serious, right?
Yeah, in the beginning.
Like dark.
Yes.
In the beginning.
Yes.
Is that much like your own personality? Because you seem pretty upbeat.
I have my moments.
You have your moments.
I don't think I'm a lot like Wednesday.
And what days are you performing?
Wednesday and Friday.
Oh, so you're Wednesday on Wednesday?
Yes.
Could it get any sweeter?
I don't think so.
We look forward to seeing you.
It's time to wake the dead.
We're here with Dylan Fennell. Dylan, welcome.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Yes, good to have you here.
Aww.
What role are you playing?
I'm Uncle Fester.
Uncle Fester. What kind of a character is Uncle Fester?
He's like a little silly, goofy guy. He's the narrator of the show every once in a while.
Oh, I did not know that. So yeah. He narrates it throughout.
A little bit, every once in a while.
And do you have any solos?
Yeah, I do. I sing a little bit by myself. I come out on stage by myself. I'm like, this is the deal. This is what's happening. It's a good time.
Do you dance?
A little bit, I do.
Okay, Bethel Park. So he sings, he dances, he narrates. Is there anything you don't do?
Have hair.
I love it. That's right, because this is
too much. This will be gone.
Right, that'll be gone by the time of the performance. Mm-hmm. So the viewers at home can look forward to seeing that.
Bald head.
And you are a senior. How
I
does
am.
It feel to be all this for your senior year?
It feels good, you know. I've been a part of the music department for the past 4 years, bringing it home. Mm-hmm. Finishing strong.
Mm-hmm.
It's good.
And do you have a favorite scene, a favorite line?
I do have a favorite line.
Oh, it's in your back pocket.
It is.
Already.
I've been preparing
okay.
for this since
All
I
right.
heard about this.
Yes.
All right. So it's not actually my line. It's between Gomez and Mal. They're talking, and Gomez, Mal goes, "Leave the door open, you hear?" And Gomez goes, "Ah, you're concerned they will make it the beast, huh?" That's my favorite line.
I love it. But what the viewers at home really want to hear,
okay.
maybe a little narration. A
little narration.
Give us like a little sidebar here.
That's right. Little Wednesday Addams, that charming, irrepressible bundle of malice, has grown up and found love.
Bethel Park, that's what it's all about. Make
oh,
sure
yeah.
you come on out and see your closing cast, correct?
I am.
So you'll be Thursday and Saturday?
That's right.
Come on out and see Dylan, you guys. We're here with Anthony Hughes. Anthony, welcome.
Thank you.
What year are you?
I'm a senior.
You are a senior. Mm-hmm. How does it feel to be performing in Addams Family for your senior year?
It's nice. It's a good like wrap up of everything.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a good final hurrah.
Mm-hmm. I love it. And what role are you playing?
I am Uncle Fester.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit about Uncle Fester?
He's Gomez's brother in the show. He's like the weird kooky side character guy.
Mm-hmm. Are you kooky in real life?
Sometimes.
You're a little
sometimes.
Kooky, right? A little fun, a little kooky.
When the opportunity is provided, yeah.
Uh-huh. And what do you do in the performance? Do you sing? Do you dance? Do you act? What is it?
Yeah, I have a solo song, a little bit of acting, and a couple like just interlude stuff that I do. So, yeah.
The people at home would love to hear a little bit of your solo.
When the daylight ends and the moon ascends. And then no anything more would be spoilers. So.
Oh, spoiler alert. Bethel Park, spoiler alert. I love it so much. What nights are you performing?
I'm performing Wednesday and Friday.
So you're opening cast.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. We cannot wait to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bethel Park, we're here with Lacey Scheidler. And Lacey, do I have to ask who you're playing?
I will be playing Grandma Addams.
Grandma Addams. Can I call you Granny?
That's fine.
All right, Granny. And how did you feel about getting this role?
I was very excited. This is my first actual leading role in the musical, so mm-hmm. I'm very excited for this to be my first
We're
role.
Excited for you.
Thank
is
you.
It a comedic role? Is it a dramatic role?
Grandma is the comedic aspect of the Addams Family. She brings the funniness, the jokes to it, and just an all-around funny person in the musical.
Is it fun to play her?
I love playing Grandma. It's definitely put me out of my comfort zone a lot, trying to figure out how to be a 102-year-old grandma, but it's a lot of fun.
And I imagine you don't use your regular voice.
I don't. I have to do like a raspy grandma type voice.
We would love to hear that grandma raspy voice.
Okay.
Define normal. That's odd. I don't really know what you're talking about.
I love it so much.
Thank you.
Now, do you do any solos or is
I
it
do
just,
not.
Just acting?
I just act.
And what nights are you acting?
I'm acting Thursday and Saturday.
So you're closing cast.
I am closing cast.
Fantastic. And you are a junior?
I am a junior.
We cannot wait to see you for the closing cast.
Thank you
so much.
Much
for making time.
Thank you.
Bethel Park, we're here with Carly Dowell, and you're playing the role of?
Grandma Addams.
Grandma Addams. What kind of a character is Grandma Addams?
I think she's really kooky. She's the comedic relief of the show. Mm-hmm. I think she provides a lot of humor within it, mm-hmm. and she just kind of protects over the family while making it humorous.
Nice. How did you feel about getting this role?
I was ecstatic. It's my first lead role in the Bethel Park Music Department, so I was just super excited, and I fell in love with the character as soon as I got the first audition packet.
That's amazing. What year are you?
I'm a sophomore.
Oh my gosh, so you have your whole future ahead with more musicals.
Absolutely, I'm so excited.
What nights will you be performing?
I'll be performing an opening cast, which is Wednesday and Friday night.
Okay, fantastic. And are you using a cane, a walker? What are you using on stage?
So I just kind of hunch over a lot more.
Okay, you're hunched over.
Yeah.
And do you have a favorite scene, a favorite line?
I love my scene with Pugsley. Just beginning to connect with him in a really fun way is so exciting.
Okay. Is there a song or is there a line that you can share with Bethel Park?
My favorite line would probably have to be, I have a rat in my hand and I say, how normal do I have to act, which is very fun.
Well, you're going to give us a taste of that. Ready? Here's your rat.
Define normal. Shh, shh, shh.
Is that you petting the
That's
rat?
That's my petting the rat.
Petting the rat. I love it so much. Bethel Park, come on out and see her. Thank you so much, Carly.
Thank you.
We're here with AJ Huber, and you're playing the role of, it looks like, Pugsley.
Pugsley,
the
yes.
The cutest Pugsley ever.
Aww.
I want to squeeze your little cheeks.
Well, I don't know. The other Caden, the little Caden.
Uh-huh.
Other
you're
Pugsley,
both adorable, right?
He's pretty
right?
cute, too, so.
Yeah, and what year are you?
I'm in 12th grade.
Oh, you are a senior. You're graduating this
yep.
year. How does it feel to do a performance as a lead as a senior?
Pretty awesome. I haven't done much with the theater here at the high school. I did mostly over at IMS. I helped a lot with stage crew, and I did ensemble once or twice.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
This
How did
is
you feel about getting this role?
I don't know. It was super exciting. It was mm-hmm. like a lot of a blur. I was just having fun, and we were all just hanging out, doing mm-hmm. our thing. So.
Well, we are excited for you. Do you have a favorite line, a favorite scene, something special you can share with the viewers at home?
Definitely my favorite scene is Pulled, because I get to scream bloody murder.
Oh, okay. Bethel Park, would you like to hear Pugsley scream bloody murder
you're
when you're ready?
You're going to
hold this. Yikes. Bethel Park, come on down and hear Pugsley scream bloody murder. What nights are you performing there?
I'm closing night, so I'll be Thursday and Saturday.
Thursday, Saturday, if you want to see this one perform. Thank you.
Thanks.
Bethel Park, we're here with Caden Smith. And Caden, what role are you playing?
I'm playing Pugsley.
Pugsley? What
yes.
kind of a role is Pugsley?
Pugsley is so fun. He's just this character who really wants to spend time with his sister.
Mm-hmm.
And when Lucas comes around, he's just really sad mm-hmm. that Wednesday's coming and mm-hmm. he can't be tortured anymore.
Right, right.
Yeah.
And you enjoy playing the role?
Yeah, I really love it.
What's your favorite line or your favorite scene?
My favorite scene is when I'm singing What If. Like, I'm really sad that Wednesday's with Lucas and I just want her to come back and be her real self.
Wait, you sing a solo?
Yes.
Bethel Park, would you like to hear this solo? They said yes.
All right.
A little bit.
Okay. What if she never tortures me anymore? How would I manage? What if she never nails my tongue to the bathroom floor?
What an angelic voice you
Thank
have.
You.
I love it so much.
Thank
what
you.
What nights are you performing?
I will be opening, so that's Wednesday and Friday.
Wednesday and Friday nights.
Yes.
And what year are you?
I'm a freshman.
Freshman, congratulations
yeah.
on getting
Thank
the lead
you.
Role. Bethel Park, come on out and see Caden.
Thank you.
Caden.
Thank you.
Bethel Park, we're here with Nathan Teets. And what role are you playing?
I am playing Lurch in the Addams Family.
Lurch? Because you're so tall?
No.
Because you're so baritone?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I have a low voice.
How did you feel about getting that role?
It's really funny. I really like it. It's a great part.
Is it a comedic role or I don't know?
Yeah, it's more of a comedic role. He kind of mm-hmm. just stands there, like mm-hmm. straight face,
and
just
walks
lurches
around. About, right?
Yeah.
Just lurches about. And what year are you?
I'm a junior.
You're a junior.
Grade.
And what nights will you be performing?
Wednesday and Friday night.
Your opening cast?
Yes.
Tell the viewers at home, give me a favorite line, a favorite scene, a favorite song, maybe. Do you do any solos?
Yeah, I do have a solo. I did last song.
Would
Move
you like to
darkness.
Share it with the public? No? Is there a favorite line, a favorite scene?
I'm not in this scene, but I love the spike chair scene.
Okay,
really
talk
funny.
To the viewers at home about it.
It's like Gomez is talking to Mal about, like, Lucas and stuff, and he just has a spike chair and shoots a thing up and tells him to take a seat, ask a question and stuff. It's really funny.
So he sits on a spike chair?
Yeah.
Bethel Park, we have to come out and see this spike chair.
It's really fun.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
We're here with Kagan Brzozowski. Welcome.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
What role are you playing in this year's musical?
I'm playing Lurch.
Lurch. Yes. The tall guy.
Mm-hmm. Tall,
this
lanky.
Guy.
Yeah, it doesn't move
guy.
Very much. Very
is it fun?
Rigid.
Is it a fun role to play?
It is, actually. I don't have a lot of lines. So.
I was just going to ask, do you have many lines or do you just grunt?
I just grunt.
You do?
All the way up until the end.
Uh-oh. What happens at the end?
I sing.
You sing a beautiful song?
I sing a beautiful song.
What is the name of the song?
Move Toward the Darkness.
Bethel Park, I have heard this song. Are you allowed to give them maybe just a little bit?
I don't know. I feel like you
please?
Might just have to come to,
if
come
we
and
say
see
pretty
it.
Please.
I'll give it a shot.
Okay.
Move toward the darkness. Welcome the unknown. Face your blackest demons. Find your bleakest bone. I'll leave it at that.
Wasn't that beautiful, Bethel Park? Thank you much for sharing that with us.
Yes.
I'm really, really touched. Are you opening or closing cast?
I'm closing.
We look forward to seeing you.
I look forward to seeing you there. Have a nice day.
Bethel Park, we're here with Dylan Lawton. Hi, Dylan.
Hi.
Hi. What role are you playing in this year's production?
I play Lucas Beinecke.
And who is Lucas?
Lucas is Wednesday's boyfriend, mm-hmm. and he's like not like the Addams family. He's definitely normal. So.
And what does that mean? He's happy? He's cheerful?
He's just like a regular teenage boy. He's
like not you.
Like, yeah.
A regular kid.
Right, yeah.
Uh-huh. Is it a fun role to play?
Yeah, I'm having a lot of fun this
mm-hmm.
year.
Mm-hmm. What year are you?
I'm a junior.
Junior, so you still have one more year to
yes.
go.
Yeah.
Yeah. How did you prepare for this role?
I was mostly just myself, I think.
Yeah.
Because I didn't have to, like, be kind of crazy or goofy, really. I could just, like, be myself, be mm-hmm. a regular teenager.
Mm-hmm. And are you opening or closing cast?
I'm closing cast.
Closing cast. Very good. And do you have a favorite scene or a favorite line that you'd like to share with Bethel Park?
I like One Normal Night the best.
What is One Normal Night?
It's a song that I sing, kind of, mm-hmm. a little bit in it. And it's a lot of fun to sing.
Go ahead okay. and sing with us.
One normal night, no, not one poem, not one inspiring word. One normal scene, complete routine, tonight can't be absurd.
Oh, I can't wait to hear you up there on that stage. Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you.
Bethel Park, we are here with Justin Minch, and you are playing the role of Lucas. Who in the world is Lucas?
Lucas is a Beinecke. He's the son of Mal and Alice. Mm-hmm. And basically, he's the boyfriend of Wednesday Addams.
Ooh.
And he's normal, and Wednesday's not, and their whole family is not. So that creates some commotion in the show.
Some commotion and some fun, I'll bet.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
How did you feel about getting this role?
I was very excited. I get to sing my favorite song in the show, which is Crazier Than You. It's mm-hmm. a very fun scene to do because you interact with Wednesday and then Mal and Alice at the end. So it's mm-hmm. really fun, and I'm really looking forward to performing it.
In front of us right now, a little bit of Crazier for you, please.
All right. I'm not impulsive, I'm not deranged, but in this moment, I know I've changed. I want to climb Mount Everest, go to Mozambique. I want to be impulsive, want to be unique. Can you believe I mean it when you hear me shriek? I'm crazier than you. I'm crazier than you. And now I'll prove to you exactly how, ow, ow.
That's fantastic. I love it so much. What nights are you performing?
Wednesday and Friday.
Fantastic. We cannot wait to see you.
Nice.
Break a leg.
Thank you.
Bethel Park, we're here with Nora Bell, or like I like to call, Alice! Hi, Nora. Congratulations on the role.
Thank you.
Yes, how do you feel about playing Alice?
I'm excited, yeah. It's mm-hmm. definitely different, you know.
How so?
Well, Alice, she comes off as this very, like, perky, very uppity, you know, kind of perfect mom, perfect lifestyle. And then, you know, she drinks the potion in the show and kind of reveals who she really is.
Mischief ensues.
Yeah, yeah.
And what's the reason for the yellow?
Oh, the yellow is kind of also just to show her very
sunshiny personality.
Perfect personality.
I
yeah.
love it. And you're a senior this year.
Mm-hmm.
What an honor having such a remarkable role. Congratulations
yeah. Thank
on
you.
That. Yeah. Are you opening or closing cast?
Closing.
You're closing cast. So you'll be Thursday and you'll be Saturday.
On stage, mm-hmm. act two.
And do you have a favorite scene or a favorite line from the performance?
My favorite line would be, "You want to act like a tool? Go sleep in the shed."
I think
that's very fun.
Bethel Park would love to hear just a snippet of a solo from your beautiful voice.
Okay.
That's everything, Bethel Park. Thank you so much for your time today. We cannot wait to see you perform.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Bethel Park, we're here with Maggie McGrath, and you are playing the role of Alice, correct?
I am, yes.
Who is Alice? Is this a new character?
In the regular Addams Family, she's not in it, so she's an added part to the musical, but she is Lucas Spineke's mom, and then her husband is Mal, and she's kind of meeting the Addams, and she's a little thrown off because it's not what she would expect, because they're just from Ohio, and the Addams, you know, they're different, so, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And what kind of a character is Alice? Is she a serious character, a comical character?
Well, she goes through a few different stages, but at the beginning, she's more happy to be there, and, you know, she's open to it, and then something happens, and she goes a little
cuckoo.
You see a different side.
Yeah. And what year are you?
I'm a senior.
Oh, you're a senior, so Yes. You're making your final musical appearance?
Yes, I am.
May I ask you, do you have a favorite line or a favorite scene from the musical?
I kind of like all of it's the scene Full Disclosure. It's at the end of the act one. Mm-hmm. This, the whole thing is really fun.
Okay.
So, and I have a song in the middle of that, which is really fun, and some interesting things happen, so... Mm-hmm.
Can you give us just a few lines or bars from your favorite song?
Sure. This is from Waiting. A woman waits for marriage. A woman waits for children. She waits for her big Mal to come back home.
All this and more can be all yours. Are you opening or closing cast?
Opening.
Opening cast. So you're Wednesday and Friday?
Yes.
Fantastic. We can't wait to see you.
Thank you.
Bethel Park, we're here with Caden Lodge, and you are playing the role of Mal. I am unfamiliar who Mal is. Tell the viewers at home.
Okay, so Mal is the dad of Wednesday's boyfriend for the play.
Mm-hmm. What kind of a character is he?
Very, very condescending and serious. Not a very nice guy.
Ooh, are you a nice guy?
Yeah, I'd like to think I am.
Okay, all right. And do you have a favorite scene, a favorite line, a favorite song?
Okay, there's this scene where I'm arguing with my wife, Alice, and I get to be very condescending in that scene, and I kind of like it.
Ooh.
A lot of expression I can
give
do.
Give Bethel Park a little bit of condescension.
All right, this is my favorite line.
Love it.
So let me get this straight. Your son, your only son, wants to marry someone who is named for a day of the week and runs around Central Park with a crossbow. And you're okay with all of that?
Oh, you did that right on point. I love it so much.
Thank you.
What nights are you performing?
I'm performing Wednesday and Friday.
Fantastic. We'll see you there.
Mm-hmm.
Bethel Park, we're here with Andrew Williams. And what part are you playing?
I'm playing Mal Beinecke.
Who is Mal?
Mal is Wednesday's boyfriend's dad.
Oh, Wednesday's boyfriend. What kind of a character is Mal?
Mal is a suburban Ohioan father who is very traditional.
Like, very conservative.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Is he a lot of fun to play?
He's a lot of fun to play. Mm-hmm. I always get the note of be more mean, be more condescending, and I like that a lot. It's a whole lot of fun.
It's fun to play.
Yeah.
What year are you?
I'm a senior.
So this is your final performance in the spring musical.
Yes, it is.
Enjoyable to play?
It is enjoyable to play.
Do you have a favorite scene or a favorite line?
My favorite scene is towards the very end of the show during a song called Crazier Than You.
Yes.
Mal and Alice and then Lucas and Wednesday do their own little separate bits. It's a partner song. We sing at the very end of the show. It's my favorite.
Could you give Bethel Park a little snippet of the song?
I learned from Lucas. I learned from you. I wasn't happy. I wasn't true, but then the way you spoke at dinner touched my soul. Completely crazy yet completely in control. And when you kicked me out, I said, let's rock and roll.
You have a beautiful voice. Thank you so much for sharing it with us today.
Yeah.
Are you opening or closing cast?
I'm closing cast.
Closing
Thursday
cast.
And Saturday.
Perfect. Bethel Park, come out and see him.
Thank you.
with the dance captains. We have Aubrey Mannion and we have Miss Elena Banks. Welcome, ladies.
Thank you.
Hello. Yes. You are the official dance captains for the Addams Family the Musical.
Yes.
Can you tell me what your role is and what it is you guys do?
We helped teach the tango, and we help people get caught up when they miss practices.
Yes, and whenever there's any lifts, we're the guinea pigs, so we always try them first.
So you guys get lifted up?
Sometimes. Uh-huh. We helped Morticia and Gomez learn the tango and, like,
all their fun lifts that they do throughout the show.
Very nice. So the tango has lifts and spins and twists and turns.
Yes.
How long's the tango about?
Like,
maybe like 4 minutes, I want to say.
4 minute tango. Yeah. But I'll bet you on the stage it seems like it's like 40 minutes.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Right? By the time they're done
and
with
learning
all that.
It. Yeah.
Yeah. And how long did it take you guys to teach them all the moves?
I'd say about like 3 or 4 practices.
Yeah.
And then
they picked
it up
on it quickly?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They're good. And what's your favorite part about being the dance captains?
I love helping everyone and I don't know, I just like being at practice, so I like the extra hours we were there.
I like getting to work with new people and dance with people I don't usually get to dance with, mm-hmm. So that's my favorite part. Mm-hmm.
And I see you do ballet in real life?
Yes.
And you do swing 1920s dance in real life?
All the time.
All the time in your spare time, right?
Mm-hmm.
Ladies, thank you so much for your time. Would you mind maybe showing us just a move or two of what you guys do? Is there a particular song that you'd like to demonstrate?
When you're in Addams, the opening dance.
Okay. Can you give us a little tidbit of that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
5, 6, 7, 8. Well, that looks pretty amazing. Would you mind teaching me a moment?
Of course.
All right. Let's see what we got. Go ahead, real quick. Here you go.
Good.
1, 2. 1, 2. Step. Step. Step.
Up.
Step. Side.
Zombie dance.
Whoa.
Shimmy.
Shimmy, shimmy, cocoa puffs. Shimmy, shimmy. Oh, okay, I got it. Okay, Bethel Park, you ready to see? Here we go. Take this.
Ready?
Okay, you could count me in.
Yeah.
Okay, ready?
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Did I do it? Do I get a part?
Yes.
Oh, thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Yay!
Death rattle.
Park, I am thrilled to have with us today Miss Jasmine Cable. Thank you for making the time to meet with us.
Thank you for having me.
I'm excited for this interview. So you are the makeup designer and coordinator for the production, correct?
Yes.
What does that mean?
I designed all the makeup looks. I drew them out, and I'm going to be applying Lurching Grandma's makeup looks, mm-hmm. and I'm also going to be teaching the other makeup artists how to do the makeup on.
Are you self-taught?
Yes.
And you post on Instagram and social media your work?
Yeah.
And how long does it take you to draw one of them?
To draw maybe like 30 minutes.
Takes you 30 minutes just to draw one makeup?
Yeah.
And do you apply it or do your people apply it?
For the leads, I will be applying it. Mm-hmm. But the other people will be applying the ensemble's mm-hmm. looks.
And you find a lot of enjoyment? You like doing this?
Yes,
mm-hmm. I do.
And what's your favorite part?
I like just being able to express my creativity mm-hmm. in it and being able to like make other people feel happy because of it.
Mm-hmm. Make them feel happy even though it's creepy and spooky and mm-hmm. scary and everything ooky.
Yeah.
Well, we're really, really excited to see all the work that you have brought to life literally up there on the stage.
Thank you.
Thank you again.
Thank you.
You gotta have a lot of passion. When you're in Addams,
you need to really love your wife.
Several times a day, you're happy when your clothes are in the mud. You smile a bit, don't follow me. You smell blood. Oh.
I want to give a great big Addams Family double snap up on top. Thank you to Mr. K, the cast and the crew, and everybody who's given time to allow us here at Bethel Park TV to interview them here today. It means so much to me, to the community, to just let them showcase their little skills. Amy Taylor, Bethel Park TV, thank you so much.
Rigor mortis! Death rattle! When you're in Addams, that's right! Obligated to the clan. It's family first and family last.